Do you ever think to yourself, what other businesses should I be invested in? Maybe it would be helpful if the businesses that you invested in were also owned by billion-dollar wealthy investors. And it would certainly be more helpful if those billion-dollar investors were buying the shares in that business that you're looking at right now. Well, you can. And I want to share with you a little trick today that we use here at Trading Mastery to help us in our due diligence when we're looking to buy a business to check to make sure a billion-dollar investor may also be buying shares in that business too. People like Warren Buffett, Carl Icahn, Monish Pupri, Guy Spier, legendary investors. Let me share that little trick with you now. Let's get over to the office. All right, so here's a little trick. Not a lot of investors know about this, but it can be useful as part of the due diligence process. Now, every super investor, anyone who manages more than $200 million in the United States, some of the big investors, Warren Buffett, Carl Icahn, David Tepper, Howard Marks, whenever they buy or sell something from their portfolio, they need to alert the Securities and Exchange Commission. And there is a particular website that tracks all of this information. And there's about 50 or 60 super investors that are essentially supplying to the Securities and Exchange Commission what they're buying and what they're selling. I mean, these are market moving investors. What they're buying, what they're selling, and all of that is collated and put on this particular website. So let's have a look at right now, and let me share with you how we actually look at it as part of our due diligence process to make sure if we're investing in a business, maybe it might be a good idea that we check to see if a super investor is actually invested in this business as well. Okay, so you can see here on the screen that all of the super investors are listed down the left-hand side. You might see a few names that you're familiar with, Howard Marks being one. Come down a little bit further, Carl Icahn right there, a legendary investor, and down here, Warren Buffett. Now, over the right-hand side here, what we can see is the top 10 most owned stocks. By percentage, they're big bets, and we can actually delve a little deeper into any one of these portfolios of these super investors like David Tepper, Monish Pupri, Michael Price, Chase Coleman. All we're going to do is click on their name and up comes their portfolio. So right here is Warren Buffett's portfolio. 44 companies, $330 billion. Apple makes up 47.6%. And you can list down here and see exactly what he owns in his portfolio. Now, what is also beneficial is that if we click on this buy button, what we can also see in any of the super investors, what are they actually buying right now? What did they buy in the last quarter? In the last 3 months, what did they buy? Well, in the case of Buffett, he bought Liberty, Cyrus, Chevron, Floor & Decor, RH, New Holdings, Activision, and Liberty Media. The previous quarter, he was buying some more Chevron and some of the other businesses there. So this can be very, very helpful. When we're doing due diligence, it's not the be-all and end-all, but one of the things that you want to make sure that you have as an investor is you want to have great quality global growth businesses, but also you want to make sure, one, you're buying them at a discount, and number two, you've got the support where you can of other super investors that are investing in these businesses. Now, it's important to note that the time that these super investors are buying the shares to the time we actually get to look on the website to actually see what they've bought and how many is generally about 3 months later. So it's not something we can use as a timing mechanism to try and speculate and jump in and buy what they're buying, because it doesn't get reported for a few months later. But it's certainly helpful with respect to when we're looking at buying a business, particularly when it's discounted, to give us the confidence. And I've done that a number of times in 2020 and 2021, and that's helped us generate the significant return on investment that we have. I put together a little video series that will share with you a little bit more detail about how we go about building great global growth portfolios that can see us earn really meaningful returns on investment. It's free to access. There'll be a link around this video right now. And when you register, I'll send you an invitation to join me in a live coaching event for an hour where you can spend time with me and let me step you through the framework and strategy we've used and continue to use to make above average returns on investment and really build your knowledge even further than where it is right now. So access that link right now, and I'll see you in that video series.